Hello everyone and welcome to this video where we'll be taking an in-depth look at Angular templates. Templates are a crucial part of Angular development, and understanding how they work can help you create more dynamic and interactive applications. So let's get started. In this particular module, you'll be learning the introduction to Angular templates, template syntax, directives, template expressions, interpolation, event bindings, and at the end of this video, we are going to have a little quiz or a little brain teaser just to get an overview of what you've learned so far in this video. So let's start off with the introduction to templates. Well, templates are essentially the HTML code used to define the structure of your Angular applications. One of the beauty of using Angular is the fact that it follows the MVC pattern, the model, the view, and the controller. With Angular, you get to have a separate file for your HTML, though you can have inline. If you don't know what that means, you can check my previous video. I explained it thoroughly. So basically, the HTML code are used to define the structure of your Angular component. They define how the user interface of your application will look and behave. Templates in Angular are passed by the framework to generate the final DOM, which is then rendered by the browser. Now let's look at the syntax used in Angular templates. Angular templates use a combination of HTML, Angular directives, and Angular template expressions. Directives are used to add special behavior to your templates, while template expressions allow you to insert dynamic data into your templates. So what are directives? Well, there are two types of directives in Angular. There is the structural directive and there is the attribute directives. Now, the structural directives such as ng-if and ng-for are used to manipulate the structure of the DOM. Attribute directives such as ng-class and ng-style are used to manipulate the appearance of the elements in the DOM. So let's look at examples of structural directives. We have the ng-if. We have the ng-for, we have the ng-switch, the ng-container, the ng-template outlet. These directives allow you to manipulate the structure of the DOM in various ways, such as adding and removing elements based on conditions, looping over collections to generate elements, and more. These directives are denoted by the asterisk symbol in the template, such as the ng-if or the ng-for. Now, these are the examples of attribute templates. Examples are ng-class, ng-style, ng-model, submit, plural, and select. These directives allow you to manipulate the appearance and behavior of elements in the DOM, such as adding and removing classes based on conditions, setting inline styles, two-way binding form input values, and more. These directives do not have the asterisk symbol in the template. So in other words, for you to differentiate between a structural derivative and the attribute derivative, the structural derivative has the asterisk symbol, while the attributes and derivatives do not have the asterisk symbol. So let's look at template expressions. Template expressions are used to display dynamic data in your templates. They are enclosed in double curly braces. Expressions can be as simple as a single property or as complex as a chain of function calls and operators. Angular evaluates these expressions and replaces them with their values at runtime. Another one is interpolation. Interpolation is a common way to display dynamic data in Angular templates. It is used to display the value of a component. The syntax for interpolation is simply double curly braces surrounding the component property, or you can call it the mustache or the mustache, if there's anything like that. So what are event bindings? Basically, these event bindings allow you to bind DOM elements, such as click, submit, input, etc., to component methods. This allows you to respond to user interactions in your templates. The syntax for event binding is the name of the event and the method in the component. For example, the click and some method binds the click method to the some method component method. All right, so these are the examples of the event bindings that we have in Angular. We have the click, the submit, we have input, change, focus, blur, mouse enter, mouse leave, key up, and key down. Right, it's time for our short quiz. The first question is, what are Angular templates? Pretty simple, huh? The second question is, dash are used to add special behavior to your templates. Then the last one is, sorry, the second to the last is, dash allows you to bind DOM elements. Dash allows you to bind DOM elements. And lastly, but not the least, directives denoted by the asterisk symbol are called what? Make sure you drop your response to this quiz in the comment section. And that's it. You now have a good understanding of Angular templates and how they work. Templates in Angular are a powerful tool for defining the structure and behavior of your components. By combining directives, template expressions, and event bindings, you can create highly interactive and dynamic user interfaces. Thanks for watching. Catch you on the next one. Bye for now.